The city of Sanibel is still working to recover almost a year and a half after Hurricane Ian. The city says crews have dumped more than 240,000 tons of sand onto the beaches to fill up what Hurricane Ian essentially washed away. Now take a look at this map here. So this shows the renourishment project's status. So you can see here, so this is the first area that's complete. So this red area all the way to the green and the blue, those areas are complete. This other area that we're focusing on is this middle section. So that's the areas that they're still working on to reach two, and the also area three. Now NBC2's Samantha Romero, she's local in that reach three area there on Sanibel. And Sam, we're expecting some closures this week as this project continues.
The Tarpon Bay Beach access where I'm standing in right now will be closed starting tomorrow for the next 2 weeks. The city of Sanibel says this will help crews bring sand equipment to fill the beaches that need sand.
My wife is a crafty lady and she likes to do things with them. She also makes Clams Casino, so I pick these up and she fills them with good stuff.
Sanibel's beaches have offered a lifetime of memories for this couple who have been coming to this beach for the past 15 years.
So we enjoy
places to eat.
Yep. And you know, we go shelling almost every day.
For them, the ongoing project to replace 400,000 tons of sand will help bring the beaches back to the ones they fell in love with.
I think it has to be done. You have to grow.
Crews have placed more than 240,000 tons of sand on Sanibel beaches so far to fill gullies and restore the beach's berm.
While the Lighthouse Beach parking lot Bayside is now back open, the Trost parking lot here will soon be closed to help crews make their way to their final sections.
The Trost parking lot and Tarpon Bay Beach access will be closed starting Monday, March 11, for about 2 weeks, with the exception of Sunday, March 17. For this couple, a new hope emerges with each newly placed grain of sand.
That was, it was hard to wrap your head around, you know, but you make the best of it, and it's still a beautiful place.
In Sanibel, Samantha Romero, NBC2.